When an individual receives mental health help from the county, they are also assigned a case manager. For now, that won't change in Mahaska County. This case manager outlines a plan and goals for individuals to focus on throughout the year. Governor Terry Branstad line item vetoed three proposals regarding mental health this past week. Community Services Director Julie Bak says case management staffing in the county should remain the same. CRI's Eduardo Zamaripa met up with Imagine the Possibilities to find out how mental health services are provided in the county and to find out what a case manager does.
Sam Collins is about to turn 20 years old. He lives in a house with three of his friends and works at the Christian Opportunity Center in Oskaloosa. He also receives assistance from Imagine the Possibilities, a nonprofit organization that provides children and adults with living skill advisors as a way to provide mental health services.
The folks that we serve are from this county, they live in this county, they are here, and our purpose, our goal, our passion is to make life work for those individuals in a productive and meaningful way in this community.
Sam has been a client of Imagine the Possibilities for 2 years. He and everyone in the house has supervision at all times throughout the day by an Imagine the Possibilities employee. Once a week, Sam has an individual session with his living skills advisor, Michaela Lewis. Michaela works with Sam and helps him with activities such as writing a grocery list, organizing his medications, cleaning his room, and doing laundry. Sam has a checklist of items he has to make sure to do every week. Michaela has worked with Sam for about a year and a half.
Seeing the difference that you make, like the people that we get from 1 year, and you see the improvement they've made in a year, that's the best part about it, because they come so far in just a short period of time.
Michaela works with Sam's case manager, Amber Horn, to execute the specific plan created to help him improve. The case manager is assigned by the county, and that aspect is independent from the assistance provided by Imagine the Possibilities.
Some of our responsibilities as case managers are to monitor and coordinate services for individuals with disabilities. Each year we get together as a team, and it's called an interdisciplinary team, and we look at kind of the progress that was made over the last year and the goals that were set.
Community Services Director Julie Bak says there's a chance the county would lose case managers depending on the funding case management services receives. That is not the case right now. If that were to happen, the state is legally mandated to provide a case manager for the individual, but the case manager would be located in a different county, which might not be beneficial.
I am the newest case manager, but there are some case managers in the office who have been here for 15 years. So they know what they need, they know if things are changing, they know what they need to do to better their plan or, you know, progress they're making. I think that that is a big advantage. You really have the opportunity to, on a day-to-day basis, or even a month-to-month basis, really get to know the individuals on your caseload.
For now, mental health services and case management will remain the same, and Sam will get ready for a big event next week.
My birthday is coming up next month on July 3rd. And probably I'm going to have my family with me, my mom, dad, and sister.
For CRI Weekly News, I'm Eduardo Zamaripa.
Mahaska County recently joined Marion and Powysheet County in the Tri-County case management. Bak says it's still too early in the process to know how mental health regionalization will end up funding or affecting taxpayers in the county.